Lana drove to this Starbucks on St. Rose Parkway in Henderson looking to pick up her next ride. But the man who requested the car didn't get in. Instead, he said the ride was for someone else, and that person she would never forget.
He was sweating, he was chewing ice, you know, smelled pretty bad, like never had a bath. So obviously he was in some kind of crisis.
Svetlana Ubers at night to make a few bucks on the side. She's dealt with aggressive passengers before, but last night she found herself in a dangerous situation.
Gentleman came in to the car, apparently was somebody else's account who told me he's gonna go with me.
She says that she had a bad feeling, but took the passenger anyway. She says he wanted to go to West Atlantic Avenue near downtown Henderson. But when they left the Starbucks parking lot, he asked for something unusual.
He asked actually for my phone first, and I couldn't give him my phone because I used the app for navigation.
And that's when Svetlana says he turned aggressive.
Through first mile, he asked me about the drop a few times, tried to intimidate me, made the comments like, oh, you never know who's picking up. It must be hard as a female driver.
Svetlana knew that something was off, and that's why she decided to pull into this McDonald's parking lot. And that's where she was forced to do the unthinkable.
He jumped, you know, across my front seat. It looked like he tried to grab me too, but I closed the door. I moved and I started running. People in drive-thru were looking at me crazy. I called the police through the Uber app.
He says the man didn't chase her, but when she looked back,
oh my God, it doesn't look like my car is there.
The man made off with her 2012 gray Nissan Altima. Svetlana says that her Ubering days are over. She wants the company to change its policy that if you request the ride, you have to take the ride.
The problem is that I'm picking up the people who I don't know who they are, who are drug addicts who can kill me or take my car.
From Henderson, Cassie Molnarek, Fox 5 News, local Las Vegas.